All right, Rafe, you ready?
You better believe it.
It's time for this week's eMemorium.
Yes, yes, yes. Welcome to this week's eMemorium, a segment dedicated to those we lost along the way somehow in the last week and a half, whether you vowed to never listen to the show again or just became enraged by some arbitrary opinion that we had the audacity of airing in an opinion-based radio show. This week's eMemorium is sponsored by our daily complainer, Donnie L. Loyal listener. Thank you. Donnie's a loyal listener who sends us instant feedback on pre-recorded shows. Guess what, man? We're not here. It's called a rewind for a reason, buddy. Do better. Grateful Dead diehards. We're sorry we, quote, don't get it, end quote, when it comes to your psychedelic stroll down memory lane, or should I say, shakedown street. I angered you when I implied that the Dead had become an unavoidable parody of itself, at being a victim of its own success. But I guess my Philistine taste just couldn't comprehend that the band that's infamous for 1960s anti-establishment acid rock associated with Allen Ginsberg, Haight Ashbury, Ken Kesey and his merry pranksters in the Electric Kool-Aid Acid Test Chronicles is exactly the same band today, noodling aimlessly for hours for fans with babies in dancing bear strollers, all while selling nachos with tie-dye tortilla chips with the help of their new edgy, controversial, bad boy lead guitarist, John Mayer. Egg on my stolen face, R.I.P. Footphobes. Some of you were not happy that we've ushered in a new era of patoots here in the Riz Studios, claiming that we have, quote, gone too far, even for this show, end quote.
Even for this show, that's the best part.
Your selective rage and prejudice over a long-ignored medical condition known as chronic blade toe has not gone unnoticed. As you cry victim and clutch your pearls while turning a blind eye and ear to almost every single segment of this show, from Freak of the Week to Headline Hooge, the things we say are heinous, disgusting, and almost always offensive. Grow up. We all got feet, and sometimes them puppies gotta breathe. 50 Toes LLC ain't going nowhere. Get used to it. And I know when Riz's mangled hoof hit the control board this week, and all its glory, that Jeff was smiling down on us saying, quote, you go, girl. End quote. Every day is a Taco Toes day, so adios, you feet elitists. One guy who was really repulsed by the phrase thick soup can Johnson during Freak of the Week.
Oh, no.
Not sure what made this phrase get your short and pricklies all up and became your line in the sand considering all of the depravity in those ads, but we can only assume you're a fan of some old-timey baseball player named Soup Can Johnson and that you feel we besmirched his good name. For that, we apologize. And you can kiss our big Thoop Can Johnson.
Thoop Can Johnson.
You killed Ray.
Here's some water. Here's some water.
Here's some water.
Oh, man, the curse of Thoop Can Johnson killed me. Let's pull this back in. Simps for Branson.
Uh-oh.
Some of you were upset that I refuted the point that Branson, Missouri was synonymous with cool. I stand corrected. How could I not see the sexy, crazy cool that the entertainment capital housing performance juggernauts like Andy Williams, Yakov Smirnoff, and the Bald Knobbers Jamboree contains? I guess I didn't realize that it was the number one destination for your widowed grandpa's bachelor party. Bye-bye, Bransonites. 30-year-olds that live with their parents and folks who left home at 18 and never looked back. Somehow, we offended both of you during a discussion about when kids should be independent. We are sorry that our personal opinions didn't match up perfectly with all of your individual life situations. To teach us a lesson, Riz has officially taken away our allowance. R.I.P. Arcades. Baja Blasters. Got a lot of emails about Taco Bell's Baja Blast when I blasted them during a Taco John segment. About how good it was and how I shouldn't bring Baja Blast into this war. Well, if it's so damn good, how come they don't sell it anywhere else?
Good point.
Does Mountain Dew not want to make money? I doubt it. Just because you've been inundated with the Taco Bell sludge and they ring out the bar mats to make Baja Blast doesn't mean that we have to like it. R.I.P. Baja Blasters. One guy who's a big-time Kopi Luwak know-it-all. Kopi Luwak is a coffee made from cat poop, and he made sure to email us to let us know that Kopi Luwak is made from civets pooping out the beans, and civets aren't cats.
Oh.
They're actually a member of the species Veriveridae, which includes other civets, genets, and spotted linsangs. Well, guess what, nerd? You missed the whole point of that story. We don't want poop coffee in our mouth. We don't care what kind of animal dookied it out. So you enjoy your cup of hot doo-doo and leave us out of it. Adios, Kopi Luwak know-it-all. And finally, lifeguards.
Oh, no.
Are bad. Some of you took it very personally that we were upset with the 15-minute reprieve of Adult Swim. And you let us know in droves that it had nothing to do with laziness on the lifeguard's part. It was people like Riz peeing in the pool. And that the pH balance had to be constantly tested, and you had to make sure there were no 7-year-olds floating on the bottom. Well, we all learned something today. But we don't apologize, and we hope you'll give us a second chance. And now, finally, to the actual RIP section of this week's eMemorium. RIP Iron Sheik. I hope you got Ted Kaczynski in a camel clutch right outside the pearly gates. Which brings me to my next RIP, the Unabomber. Ted Kaczynski. He finally passed on to that big post office in the sky. And hopefully, they'll read his manifesto. And other than that, I'll turn it over to the group. That concludes this week's eMemorial.
Thank you, Rafe.
Thank you.
Wow. Brings a tear to my eye every time.
Mm-hmm. Soup can got me today. Soup can scythe tear just rolled down my face.
Thick soup can,